When I look back and think of all the things we've done and how it all started, it's pretty amazing. If he was playing for five people or if he was playing for 2,000 people, he would play with the same intensity. And also the way he presents his product, I think it's also parallel to none. I think jazz musicians can get a little lazy when it comes to presentation. I think you should be an amazing musician, you should be incredibly well prepared, but I think you have the task of entertaining people as well. It's not only about the music, I think. I don't want to play gigs. I want to play events. People want to come to my gig and be like, wow, that was something special. And it doesn't have anything to do with the size of the venue or the size of the PA or the amount of lights you have on stage. I think you can make an event at a little coffee shop with, 10 people. And I think people's attention span has dwindled since social media started being so big. I think people have just this temptation to go to their phones all the time and be distracted. So I think if you present your music in a way that is going to keep people's attention, then they're going to have a little bit more of a threshold on how long they can stay with you. Another thing that I learned from Pat is his lyricism also makes people stay with the music. He draws a straight lines through a song, or he gives something to the audience to latch on to. And it can be very complex, it can be very sophisticated, but there's always something, either a groove or a melody, especially melodies with Pat, that people can latch on to. And that way we can play, 3-hour shows and people kind of stay with us, which is pretty amazing.